very much for giving me the opportunity to present in this education course of ARVO. And my topic will be about the European reference networks for rare diseases, and more specifically for rare eye diseases. So European reference networks have been launched in 2016 by the European Commission. And their ERNs means European Reference Network for Rare, Low Prevalence and Complex Diseases. Rare diseases in Europe is more than 30 million of persons who are concerned. There are more than 6,000 rare diseases overall. And their definition is that it affects less than one person in 2,000. 80% of these diseases are genetically determined. So there is a huge public health issue to address all the patients with rare diseases in Europe. And that's why the European reference networks have been launched by the Commission. So there are 24 ERNs, European reference networks, that addresses different fields of rare diseases, one of which is rare eye diseases. The goals of these ERNs is really to improve the patient trajectory in the EU. And one of the main tools of the ERN is the virtual clinic. The second goal is to reduce the inequalities of the access to care for patients in the EU and reduce that time to diagnosis. And this is a major issue for rare diseases. And there, with the big evolutions in genomics, it's also that all the patients can have access to genetic diseases. So many people in rare diseases remain undiagnosed, either on clinical grounds or on genetic grounds. So we really have to aim to reduce this delay to diagnosis, the odyssey for diagnosis. And a very important goal for ERN-EYE is also to facilitate the involvement of patients in clinical trials. So the patients have to get access to innovation, and we hope that ERNs will be a tool to facilitate the access to innovation. And in addition, we have really to disseminate training and educational programs to all our members and to all the people who can be concerned in Europe about rare diseases, and here more specifically in rare eye diseases. So how does an ERN work, and how is it built up? There is a coordinating group, management group, that is based actually in my hospital in Strasbourg. And we collaborate with 28 other partners, members of the in 13 member states of the European Union. There are 29 founding members, and the ERNs are expanding because there is a new call for membership that is currently ongoing. In addition to members, we have affiliated partners who are also very precious partners for us. And today we have 13 associated national centers and three hubs, meaning places where people, where there are merged resources for rare eye diseases, one of which being dedicated to ophthalmology. Today, how do we function with ERN-EYE? We have four thematic groups on rare eye diseases. The first working group is about retinal rare eye diseases. The second group is dedicated to neuro-ophthalmology. The third to pediatric ophthalmology, and the fourth to anterior segment rare eye diseases. So it's like a specialized clinics, virtual clinics, that are addressing in these fields rare eye diseases. In addition, we have transversal working groups that address different questions. First question is the low vision, the daily life, and how patient groups can interact with all the professionals and between them. There is another transversal thematic group that is dedicated to genetic diagnosis, and this is extremely important today. Another working group is focusing on registries and epidemiology. Of course, we have a transversal group on research, and then we have two groups that are dedicated to communication, education, and training programs. So all this is organized in a way where we interact very much between professionals, but also with the management team that is located in Strasbourg. We are lucky to have European leaders who are involved in running these working groups and the transversal working groups. And you can see on this slide the names of all the colleagues who really dedicate that time to the European Reference Network, and this is highly important because we need to have a top-level expertise to share our knowledge and also to disseminate our knowledge for the best care of the patients. So we have achieved since 2016 a few missions. One of our first aims was to address the question of ontology and how to name and classify rare eye diseases. As you know, there has already been a lot of actions provided by various structures like Orphanet or HPO, Human Phenotype Ontology, and we worked with these structures to revise and revisit the different classifications dedicated to rare eye diseases. And this was our first step, was a first workshop with all our colleagues, which was held in Saint-Odile in October 2017, where we really worked with all our members, but also the representatives of the different structures such as Orphanet and HPO to revisit the ontologies and how we're going to characterize our different symptoms and also our different diseases in future databases. So it was extremely important to us to try to clarify the ontology that will be used in the future for many databases, for registries, but also for the case patient management system. That is one of the central tools of the ERNs, and also to see how we will liaise with various things such as biobanks. To improve the clinical care of patients with rare eye disease in Europe, the European Commission has provided a tool that is called the CPMS, the Case Patient Management System. For this matter, we have collaborated with the Commission to elaborate a specific data set for ophthalmology in addition to all the different data sets that were already running and common with the other ERNs. So the principle of the CPMS is that the patient comes in one of our healthcare providers' clinics, and if the patient has a specific question to be addressed to, or if it's specifically difficult case, the practitioner can enter the data of the patient in this CPMS after having, of course, obtained the consent of the patient. And his clinical data will then be shared with the different members of the working group that is concerned by the disease of the patient, for instance, if it's a retinal dystrophy, by the retinal group. And these experts will share the knowledge around this case and will deliver a recommendation that will be given to the practitioner. So the patient will be able to benefit of the common expertise. To facilitate the use of this clinical patient management system, there has been a lot of efforts from the ERN-EYE to go towards our practitioners with some guides, a help desk, and various tools such as webinar and training sessions that have been put in place to help our practitioners and our colleagues, our members, to use. The third aspect we have been working on recently is about how to collect data on our different rare eye diseases in a systematic way. And this is about a registry, who is a basic registry for rare eye diseases in Europe. And this is going to be a major step because all the ERNs have been granted to build up a registry. And it will be a secured system, a GDPR compliant system, and we will also have to fit to what is called the FAIR principles: findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable data. So we have worked on a model. So each of our partner, each of our members in each hospital will collect the data of their patients with specific European systems for the pseudo-anonymization, and they will be in charge of the data that will be collected. Then this data will be analyzed at the level of a European platform, the ARVO platform, in the shape of a metadata analysis. So this is really an excellent opportunity for us to share the data of rare eye diseases and to improve our knowledge anyhow in epidemiology, and also to be able to find patients afterwards for trials, for instance. So our data set includes an obligatory data set provided by the European Commission and many various European work groups. And this data set will be shared with all the ERN's registries. So we will be able to share, for instance, demographic data in between us. But of course, as we are addressing the questions of rare eye diseases, designed specific data elements to collect specifically rare eye diseases elements. So what is important is that this is a very basic registry, but in the future we will be able to plug in more specific registries on very specific diseases, or to address very specific matters for each rare eye diseases. In addition to all this, we are designing and we will propose very soon an e-learning program for the professionals. So again, this e-learning program is it will be very important to disseminate the knowledge and to be able to train professionals, scientific professionals or medical professionals, to the field of rare eye diseases. And we will address different topics such as retinal topics, but also genetic testing, and also anterior segment conditions. So we will be quite wide in the coverage of the rare eye diseases. So during the last 3 years, we have also been able to set up workshops for our members, and we have been able to invite most prestigious speakers, and we tried really to address the questions that are very relevant to us, such as genetic testing, as well as gene therapy, for instance, for the last workshop. So this has really enabled the European experts to liaise around these topics. What is very important also for us is to educate professionals. And for this matter, we have designed educational videos, and one of which has a lot of success. And it's about how to take care of a patient in a hospital, a patient who has visual impairment. And there is a lot to learn for all the medical professionals about this. And I invite you to have a look at this video, and also to disseminate it to your colleagues.
During a consultation, whatever the specialty, you should assist a blind person while keeping some simple precautions in mind. Introduce yourself to the person. Gently brush their hand before shaking it. When going to an exam room, offer the person your arm or shoulder. and explain the journey you're about to make. During the exam, say very naturally, at normal volume, the actions you're going to perform.
To finish, we are ready to interact with any of you in any field concerning rare eye diseases. Merci beaucoup.